Welcome, everyone, to the Argian Freedom Cup qualifiers. I am Sprawl. By my side, the one and only Hano. How's it going, buddy? Are you excited for this match or what?
I am. Should be kind of a one-sided match, but I'm curious to see what Dream Tanks does here and see if they can hold off an ICT set on Cash. Cash is the old Dust 2 of CSGO, that's for sure.
Yeah, I would have to agree there. And we're going to see Dream Tanks start on the CT side. We're going to have to deal with this B-side bust, though, as Nexus looks like that is their target for this pistol round, and they're going to find two entries on their way in. Planks does go down, and actually they're going to take down Alien there as he tries to make his way into Checkered as well. So Kamenar and Vanguards, two left up to try and retake. They do not have a kit in their possession. I'm not going to lie, I'm not 100% certain if there's one in sight here. Doesn't look like it's going to make a difference. So Drone, two big frags for him, and Xavier, three for himself as well. Nexus with a really nice start here on Cash, and like you had stated, it could be a one-sided affair here. Again, if you look at the lounge odds, there's a reason why it is fairly lopsided. Nexus, they've had some pretty decent results lately. There's been a couple different renditions of this lineup, this being the latest, obviously. But they've showed some impressive stuff. Dream Tanks, we looked up a little bit on them. I think they just made it out of open and such, and now they're competing in IM, so might be able to challenge these guys, and they're going to have some pistol armor here to do so.
I think the aggressive pistol strat by them in the very beginning. A lot of teams now are doing aggro pistol strats. There's not much of a slow T-side pistol strat anymore. It's mostly just 5 or 4 man armor up. If they do a 4 man armor up, they'll have another guy with utility nades, and they usually just take something quick, fast, and aggressive.
Looks like we are going to see Char pop open Squeaky Door here. He's going to send a Molotov over towards Fork, and they're going to go with a pretty kind of slow and careful A take, where they're just going to utilize some Molotovs. And this is something that we actually see Cloud9 do on this map, where it's very Sean Gares-esque. He'll get everybody to purchase some Molotovs, and they basically just take away certain locations. This is not going the way Nexus was hoping, though, as they are losing a number of members. Xavier down to 9 hit points. Planks has made it to quad, and we'll spot one out from Fork, but this is looking really dangerous, and actually a bit of a botched flashbang there. Xavier's still inside of A main. He's going to catch another one crossing. There's a little bit of damage to him. Planks needs to come up big, though, and he goes down. Now it's only Xavier left, and he needs to come true to his name here if he wants to collect this round, as he's got 25 seconds. And honestly, Dream Tanks with an excellent setup. The minute Xavier walks out of A main here, he has a ridiculous crossfire to deal with as he's checking towards Fork. He actually blindsides one of them as they suspect he could have made it back towards Highway, but it will be Thugwaffle to peek out and take him down. So yeah, Nexus, I like the idea as the Molotovs and such, but apparently Dream Tanks, it didn't really make a difference. They're still hitting their shots in that main part of the site.
There's a lot of money too. I mean, they bought up Galils, Tech-9s, some Mech-10s. No AKs, fortunately. The CTs actually didn't pick up any of the Galils, but the strat, they use the Molotov to flush out the back of Quad, and they use the Molotov to flush out underneath AC as well. But that 5-7, and beautiful by the CT side, the 5-7s in that site, extremely deadly. You can hold an angle while your teammate plays Quad, and you don't even need a guy Quad there. So maybe a little bit sloppy from the Terra side, but great hold by the CTs.
See a bit of an A bust here as Alien takes down 3. Xavier is going to find one, actually a second. Makes it a little bit expensive. At least getting those 2 frags will keep that economy at an even level here for the Dream Tanks crew. And again, they went with SMGs there, so going to have a little bit more in their bank account as well. So losing the 2 players, they have made up for it with the SMGs. But again, moving into this round, we see Thugwaffle going for an M4. Actually, 2 M4s. As the T side's still going to be saving, we actually see a couple Deagles making it onto the field, and actually a couple smokes as well here.
I'm not sure if they have the smoke grenades to try to get like a plant in the A. I think that might be the case, but if you're buying a Deagle, 4 people boosting, I think they're just going to try to get some headshots here and try to out-aim these guys, but with an M4, that's going to be extremely difficult for them to do so.
I would have to agree. See if they have any luck doing so as MNR. He's going to spot some players at White Box here. He goes with 4 shot as well as Char. Just a little bit of damage dealt to him. 50 hit points remaining, but we'll stand strong here. Actually sends another pop flash towards middle. He peeks out wide and we'll take him down to 22 now. Still not dead yet though, and actually Drone takes down Thugwaffle. So all of a sudden, they will be able to find at least one for themselves, and Parole actually right underneath vents if they decide to take into B. And yeah, that looks to be the case here as 2 more T's bite the dust. Planks last one up. He's going to try and take away any more weaponry if he can. He's doing a little bit of damage to Alien here. Downside is he's got a Glock, and at that kind of range, it more or less tickles. And it's actually Parole takes him down with an HE, so 3-1. Dream Tanks, nice start here. Certainly a great scoreline considering they lost Pistol.
Absolutely. And they don't have the spawn for the op, though, so I'm kind of curious to see where he's going to play. I'm also curious to see if they're going to do the 2-1-2 setup on CT side, or if they're going to throw a 1-3-1 CT setup. Gun round, first gun round, always a huge round and important. Looks like they're going to go with something a little bit less standard. A 1-2, or a 2-2-1, rather. I don't know. No, they're going to set the 1-3-1. So I like this. Any mid aggression, obviously mid is important on this map, so they're going to try to shut down that early mid aggression and make sure they can't take control of it, the T's can't take control of it, rather. And the T's are looking towards that B bomb site, and they're going to have one lurker maybe towards the door to throw a little bit of a fake.
And we can see, I'm a little curious, look at Vanguard's for a second. Why does he have a knife out in this position? I honestly have no idea.
I'm not entirely sure
like
either.
Alien, I can see, he's jiggle, like Alien is jiggle peeking the side of the site. It's a pretty common thing to do with the knife out. You got pretty quick acceleration and such, and you can usually get out of there before they tag you up. But Vanguard's on the other case. He will go back to his rifle in hand, so I'm not really sure, but just living life on the edge, right? As it does look like the B-side take here is going to be the name of the game. Molotov's raining in. We see them entering from Checker. Dugwaffle goes down immediately. His teammate to follow, and no frags go in the way of the CT side. Alien just going to rush through the smoke, and he actually does find one as Holy Blind Char was hitting at headshot. So 3-on-3, Nexus without control of the bomb site here, and this is where things start to get worrying. They got very little time to actually make this happen, and the CT's got actually a pretty excellent crossfire, but they're going to rotate back. Vanguard's not believing that they're going to continue on, and to be fair, they actually did delay long enough that it could definitely be the read on the situation. Vanguard's now way on his way back, and he's going to get caught out in CT spawn. 13 hit points remaining. Kam-NR up in heaven, and he loses his teammate now. Last one up with his op in hand. I got to think he wants to go for the save. Just kidding. Takes down four shot. Both of these guys fairly low, but with an op in hand. This is a difficult retake. Tries to find the flick on a savior. Playing a bit of an unorthodox angle, just standing at headshot there. And yeah, Nexus, to be fair, I thought when they got those two initial frags, it was going to be a lot cleaner of rounds. So good on Dream Tanks for making it competitive, but Nexus, they just bide their time and eventually take in.
It's the second time that Alien Tech, or Alien rather, has gone through the smoke and CT. Sometimes it's a risky play, but it paid off for them there. Breaking down the way the terrorist site took the site, they smoke off the very entrance so that no ops or rifles can actually see through. And if the CTs aren't playing in checkers, they can get into checkers, slow it down a little bit, then they can get easier smokes and easier nades into the bomb site. If you're not peeking, obviously you can bank them off the wall and you can smoke CT spawn. You can also molly headshot. You can also do that from sunroom as well, but just makes it a little bit easier. And if you can outshoot your teammates, or outshoot the other team, rather, then taking that checkers makes it a lot easier for you to take the B-bomb site. So they did that once they got hold of that checkers, and like you said, they almost lost it, though. Alien Tech coming through.
We actually see a pretty cool strat here in that we just saw a Molotov from, I believe that was Savior, tossing it into Vents, and the play there, its four shot is actually in Sunroom. So if there's a player inside of Vents when that Molotov lands, more than likely, he has to retreat to checkered and drop out of the vents, and that's where Foreshot capitalizes on that exact play. So, really nice play that, quite honestly, I'd like to see more often on this map, as it is a pretty tricky one, especially if you got that read in. But Dream Tanks on a save here. We will find one Deagle frag. That's Alien to pick it up as they enter into the A bomb site for the T side. Now, we see Parole going to group up with his teammate, Thugwaffle, all the way up towards Highway, and actually finds an AK, and he spots out Planks, doesn't take a shot immediately though, as, oh, we wanted to line something better up, and Planks actually ends up finding him. It's Alien and Parole left. Try to go for that AK with Parole. Alien gonna go down right after his teammate, and 3-3, Nexus kind of bringing their way back in here. Again, Dream Tanks, it was great, the fact that they were able to take the round after Pistol and put three on the board, but now when we're seeing rifle rounds, Nexus seeming to have their way, but we will see another rifle round here from Dream Tanks.
It's important for Nexus to actually win that round with four people alive. They can stabilize their money a little bit more. If, you know, say one stayed alive, they might not be able to buy if the CTs win this round here, but since they did win with four people alive, they can stabilize a little bit more, grab a little bit more cash. They have full nade sets, four mollies from the terror side, smokes. They can do pretty much whatever they want. They can take mid control, they can do an A strat, B strat. When you have that money, you have a lot more options, obviously, with the utility. and see what happens.
Actually gonna see a little bit of damage dealt the planks as he's up near vents, and actually a Molotov, he retreats in good time as Foreshot actually goes down to Cam NR, which is still at sandbags here, and planks has a read on it, tries to find the headshot, and actually he does lose his teammate. Alien goes down. Cam NR actually does peek out and finds one before going down. So they will at least create a 3-on-3, and Thug Waffle right underneath the vent here. He takes down the first one. Xavier trying to actually spray from the vent, but it's Drone from B main that will be able to connect. So Parole is going to try and spam through the smoke, and that's a bit of a risky play. Again, obviously, he catches him on the cross. Fantastic, but if he doesn't, you know exactly where he's at now. Vanguard's moving up towards heaven. And 2-on-2, especially with the bomb set, definitely advantage Nexus as that smoke not going to dissipate as quickly as maybe Parole had hoped, and he's gonna actually flash towards that headshot area. Vanguard's doing similar things up in heaven. He's gonna play one and back, plat that Savior, and gonna get brought down very low. Eventually goes down, Drone last up. The plant is for him, so how does he play it here? He actually gets taken down as trying to read into maybe the sound cues there, as he had one player very near to him, one looking to jump on the bomb, and Vanguard's with the kit, barely brings that defuse in, but good retake. Again, 2-on-2, Nexus with that smoke down. You would think they would have a bit of a better time, but Dream Tanks, they bring it home.
They hit a lot of Molotovs. I don't understand. Savior was middle, and so was in Foreshot, but Savior has a Molotov. There's a little lip that you can throw nades and Molotovs against by sandbags in mid. I don't know why he just didn't throw that and flush the CT out. The CT cam was allowed to stay there and pick up two frags from it. So when you have the utility, use it. Don't sit back and try to out-aim the guy or wait for him to peek. Flush him out of there. Use your nades and get something going with your teammates.
Yeah, certainly as Cam NR was allowed to create really big defense inside of middle there. And actually in this round, oh boy, he is pushed all the way into mid-warehouse. So now, oh, he might actually catch out Planks here. Planks does send one nade over. Planks actually holding for the specific push. He's going to send a molly out. He's got to read that there's actually a player pushed up here, and the read is a solid one. He must have spotted a shoulder or something to that effect when he threw that smoke over. Otherwise, I really don't know how he read that way. Planks, just a cerebral play, and he's actually going to take another one down in middle as well.
Possibly a gun barrel. I think that might have been the case.
Especially with the silence. That actually does stick out fairly far. So I think you're onto something there, as it was kind of right on the hinge of being spotted and peeking out wide, and yeah, I think he was just a little bit visible. Nonetheless, taking towards B here, and we can see this is actually the site that if the CTs would choose one site for them to hit, they would be happy with it to be B, as they've got two defenders. Vanguard still towards the A bomb site. Deals with Char, so we got a 3-on-3. Again, they're going to have to deal with two players inside of the bomb site. Roll and Thug Waffle both coming up with frags. Thug Waffle with a hat trick in the round. Going to get an op for his effort as well as Dream Tanks on 5 rounds here. Good work from them as they're going to put the T's back on Eco.
Not only was that a 3v5, but they got the first two. The terrorist side got the first two opening picks. Planks got two picks, 3v5, and they sent the CT side still ended up winning. That's incredible. Great hold by them in the B site. And the thing that I like, even though it didn't pay off for them, is that the CT actually pushed up into mid. We've seen so many times with these teams that are like, 90-10 percentage on CSGO lands. So they play so passive, and they let teams do whatever they want, and they're not. They're getting aggressive. They're making sure that they're checking the terrorist squad and making sure they're doing things correctly, but we got a fast day.
Here we go, as fast day is underway. Vanguard's playing behind the smoke fence, and Alien actually sent down to 17 hit points. He's going to go down immediately here. And actually, Cam NR finds one. Vanguard's with two near fence. Great defense as Planks. Foreshot last one's up, and we actually see Foreshot go down. Planks lurking inside of the bomb site. If we can find Vanguard's towards the fence position. This is a bizarre setup here. Finally, Planks going to get spotted out. Cam NR actually near E-Box. Going to call it. Vanguard's, did you not check site? He was right in front of you. Nonetheless, it will be 6-3 as the A-Bus just not going to work out. And yeah, just to further what you were saying in the previous round, the fact that the T-Side getting two entries and then not able to close their round, that is, again, just a tribute to Dream Tanks really doing big things here. And again, like we were stating, the aggressive nature. If you're playing not to lose, it's different than playing to win. And I think that's what we usually see from teams, that they are the huge underdog. They're just afraid that if they make these bigger plays, maybe a giant mistake's going to show up that no one has ever exploited, and it's just not a good idea overall. When in theory, trying to catch your opponents off guard with some aggressive play might be exactly what you require.
The aggressive play didn't help them on CT side there, but still, like you said, you just gotta do it. You gotta throw the tees off. It might work one round and might not work the other, but you need to mix that into your playbook. And I would really, really like to see Nexus to actually do fast drafts of their own. Drone picking up two kills here and taking the bombs. I can dick down one as well. Planks is down.
We're gonna see just the two CTs from Highway. Thugwaffle coming up from Truck, and this is looking like a good round here thus far from the Nexus side. Four left alive in a post plant with smoke still down. And four shot actually with the Molotov as well. So we'll see if that comes into play. As you can see, they're going to attempt to take out Char with the first frag. He peeks out from four. They do take down Char, but after that occurs, the rest of his team peeks out and deals the damage. Nexus now up to four. So on their T side, to be fair, I think the Nexus is a decent team on either side of the map. So for Dream Tanks to have a really good look here, I'm thinking they want to put away as many rounds as possible, but I think that's maybe where we might see the aim of Nexus come into play on their CT side holds and such. Not that they're having a bad T start here, but what do you think in scoreline for Dream Tanks? What do you think they shoot for?
I mean, obviously you want as much rounds as possible, but I think that they shoot for like a 9-6, but Nexus... Sorry about that, turn my volume down a little bit. Nexus, you're right, they're more of a skill-based team, right? So they've had some roster changes, they've had some roster issues, and they're trying to come up with Planks and Foreshot coming onto the squad. But we know that Planks and Foreshot are really strong fraggers, and so is Drone and Char. So if these guys are on CT side, they can kind of play what they want to do on CT side rather than push into the CT. So as you're playing as a CT player, I agree with you. I think that they're going to get a lot more rounds on that side. So Dream Tanks, if you want to win this, you got to get at least maybe 9 or 10.
Yeah, I think that is an accurate scoreline as they're going to try and take into B here. Hammond R and Thugwaffle both coming up with frags. Bro still alive in the bomb site as well as Planks fully white screen. He is going to push up a headshot and does deal the damage to Parole, but Alien peeks in from heaven. Takes down one now. It's four shot. 1v2. He's got 35 seconds here. The bomb not exactly in his grasp, and quite honestly, it's in a pretty vulnerable position. As he's going to peek up towards heaven, and as we can see, Vanguard's actually playing CT spawn, but up on a box where his teammate is rotating. Now, does four shot? He doesn't have enough time to really look for a frag before getting this bomb down. A lot of situations, you want to find a 1v1 before getting this. But again, with the time he is given, he's going to go for it. Oh, and he misses a flick onto Alien, and that's going to be it. I still like the play. He looked for a 1v1 as Alien's taking into the bomb site. He's just going to miss his shot.
Yeah, if he had more time, I think that he would have maybe pursued the guy into CT a little bit longer or a little bit more in-depth. But yeah, you're right. If you're in a 2v1 situation, you need to create two 1v1s. He was looking for it, didn't get it. Good play by the CTs. I'm actually quite impressed by Dream Tanks. They're playing good, solid Counter-Strike. They're not making many mistakes. I mean, they're playing the way they would play against anybody else. Not just, okay, we're playing at Nexus. They're a good team. We got to do things differently. They're playing the way they seem that they want to play, and I like that. I think that they're comfortable, and I think that's why they're picked up seven rounds right now, and Nexus doesn't look too hot. I don't think that... they're not playing against a team that they think that they can outshoot, it feel like. I think that they need to get aggressive, and they just haven't. They keep doing these little executes and taking little pieces of the map, but not quite doing anything with it.
Looks like they are going to go for a bit of a quick play towards A here. Squeaky being the major focus. Alien going to drop down from Catwalk, but his Vanguard's with three. Alien comes up with one as well. Actually, almost, I think he almost killed his teammate there, but nonetheless, they get the job done, and yeah, Vanguard's nice 4K from him. Almost finds that eco ace, and Nexus goes for the fast play. One of the things I've noticed, though, like you're calling for fast plays. They've done fast plays, but it's only been on ecos. I don't think we've seen, other than Planks taking out middle, finding two entries in a bit of a quick fashion, possibly, or something to that effect. We've seen minor quick plays, but not like a hole on from front to start or beginning to end, that full play with full equipment as well.
I want to see a quick mid. I mean, I want to see the first spawn get right up on that box, boost two people up, use your Molotovs, use your nades, and get that mid control. I mean, the guy's playing sandbags almost every single round. They have a guy white box as well. Take that control, take mid control. Once you get mid control, you can go anywhere on the map. You can stop rotates, you can go vents to B, you can go cat to A or highway to A. I mean, you have a lot of options once you take mid control. And it seems like they're just going A and B every single round. That's it. You should have an A strat and a B strat. That's all they got.
More avenues of attack as well as more options, but they try and just take out A main, a little bit of squeaky presence, and they trade one for one. Kaminar goes down. Char Char gets dropped as well. So 3-on-3, drone a little bit lit up, and CTs are very quick to the bomb site. This is actually something we've seen a trend. The rotation times are pretty darn good here as they are very quick to the scene. As we can see, one player inside of A main that's getting thrown, and actually Four Shot takes down Vanguard's. Traded off. Drone finds his frag at A main, leaving Thug Waffle. Last one up. Plank's gonna have to retreat from that quad area as he's incendiaried out. Drone gonna have to peek as Thug Waffle, he sticks it, but he gets off of the bomb, and that could be it here. Drone certainly has taken this round. He's gonna try and book it away. Yeah, Thug Waffle finds the frag, makes it actually as expensive as possible, which is not exactly the best news for Nexus, but they secure the round in their fifth.
This round's gonna be important. It's gonna almost create two rounds for either team, depending on who wins. So the money situation is quite poor on both ends. Whoever snags this round probably snags the next after that, depending on if they can, you know, have a nice counter eco or anti eco. But CT side, no ops. T side, no ops. A lot of rifle and rifle action going on. And again, we're gonna have two people heading towards that B, so maybe they'll smoke off the entrance and try to take control of the checkers again and execute one more time on that B site rather than taking mid or A.
Cam and R are gonna push through middle here, and we've seen him do this before. He takes down one, but he will be traded off immediately thereafter. So pretty good damage control there from Nexus. One for one trade will favor them slightly. It looked like he may have been able to get a little bit more done. The timing was differently, but that is CS for ya. As now the CT's playing 2-1-1. Two in A, one in middle, one in B. So there's a weakness here in Pearl. Oh boy, I'm not gonna lie, I'm having flashbacks. I matched Make yesterday, I played that exact same spot, and just, it's so difficult to dodge a flashbang that comes out of mid-warehouse like that. Fully blind as Pearl, and he goes down as they take out middle towards Vince. Now, we'll rotate Alien back through CT spawn. He's not exactly present yet, though. He's actually gonna spam a little bit through the door towards checkered, but it's Thug Waffle who is gonna be secluded from his teammates. Taken down actually immediately as Alien gets a fortunate frag through the smoke. Char very low. Will go down, so we'll be a 2-on-3 here. Vanguard speaking from the site, does deal with Savior. And this is excellent. They're just chipping away at the defense of now the post plantees. Alien not gonna peek towards underneath the heavens, and Planks actually will deal the damage to Vanguard's up in heaven. So great round there from Nexus. They work towards B, they find a frag, and then they work towards the weakness.
Here's that very low economy we're talking about last round. Vanguard's is going to actually have to pick up a pistol, same thing with Thug. It looks like Alien might do so as well. Cam doesn't have enough money for a Famas either. We're going to have one rifle on the CT side, but they do pick up multiple nades, so maybe they'll do like a flash peek. If I was on the CT side, I'd go with the Famas, say, hey, I'm going to flash into A main. A flash into B. Let's pick up a gun for one of our teammates and try to even this out a little bit. It doesn't look like there is going to be any aggression at all except for that door.
Four Shot already taking some pot shots, but it's a squeaky push that will be dealt with as we see Alien and Pearl go down. As now NR, Thug Waffle, and Vanguard's. They are going to be more stacked towards A. Actually, Thug Waffle pushing through middle here, and he might be able to find a timing as, oh, Savior is actually watching it, the insta-dink from Thug Waffle, but he cannot collect the frag. Unfortunate stuff for him, but good news for Nexus as they will get their seventh round. Good news as definitely Dream Tanks looked very, very solid early on after taking that second round after Pistol. Put a lot of numbers on the board, but I do think Nexus with the comeback on seven, maybe a little bit more than Dream Tanks wanted to give up there.
Bit surprising that they had, you know, eight rounds, I agree, and good showing, at least. I thought it was going to be a little bit more of a stomp, but like we were expressing, is that when you play against a team that you think is better than you, you have to play your game, or else you're going to fall into their game, and obviously they're going to be the better team at their game. It's just the way it is. If they're a better Counter-Strike team, then you have to do your own thing. Do a little bit something random, a little bit of cheese, whatever you want to do, but Dream Tanks, maybe they have some surprising strats. Let's see what's going on, and I'm kind of curious to see what we have for buys here, if we're going to get armor from the T side, or if we're going to get some nades, and one smoke grenade, and three armors, four armors, Cam, what you want to do?
He is thinking about
there
it.
There we go, so there's armor. That armor. Four armor, one nade set. A lot of teams are doing this right now, and looks like they're going to head towards A with that, that squadron of Ts.
No, not a bad plan at all, and actually Nexus playing a retake on the site. And the way they're going to drop a smoke towards truck, Force Shot, it's actually very difficult for him to find any entry frags if they get that smoke down properly. And that's exactly the case. Going to get a free bomb plant, almost. Force Shot actually going to burn Kam and R to death. And interesting as he just decides to get that bomb set, even though he's burning to death, but nonetheless, 5-on-4, as again, this is the strategy from the CT side. They know they got no entries other than that burn to death frag, but it's gonna be the Dream Tanks here getting 2 on their way in. They're gonna be a 2-on-3 as Vanguard's, he is going to lose Pearl, Plank stealing the damage there. Vanguard still alive underneath the catwalk. Plank's with 8 hit points. My god, I've never seen someone with 8 hit points take so long to go down. Eventually, Vanguard's gets him down, but in the process, the bomb is defused, and that is the round for Nexus.
The Savior actually had a kit there, so I'm kind of curious why he didn't. But the CT setup was really well done. B is obviously the harder site to retake on this map, so if you're gonna stack something, you want to stack B on Pistol Round. So they played a little bit further back. They had one guy play with a USB on truck, and then he had a set Molotov, which is an awesome Molotov to learn. If anything's important on this map, learn a Molotov from truck that lands in that default plant spot. It'll help you out tremendously. So what he did was he just threw a Molotov. Once he knew that they were planning default, picked up a frag from it, and the CTs retook after that. So a great CT side, perfect team setup on Nexus. And Dream Tanks, good strat, they just couldn't hold post plant.
Looks like Dream Tanks is going to go for basically a full save. They're going to be able to afford AKs in this next round, so try and do some damage to these players in A, and actually they find 2 frags out of it. They can get another bomb plant here, that'd be fantastic, and it does look like it will be set. Char will be able to take down Parole, but he goes down to Alien, and now we got a 2-on-2. Alien gets dropped. I go out full with a Glock. I gotta say, I'd be surprised if he's able to clutch this, especially with a Glock in hand, but it's not out of the realm of possibility. Oh, he's gonna have his shoulder spotted from Savior up on top of, or I think that was Savior, one of the two. Drone, actually, I believe, was hopping up above. So he spotted out, and they will spam him down. So Nexus now with a 1-round lead, 9-8, and this is where we are going to see this buy come in for Dream Tanks, but if they don't take this round, this is where things maybe on the Dream Tanks start to get worrying, as they really did come up with a pretty damn good scoreline moving into this half. But Nexus, if you allowed them to build up a little bit of economy here, it's going to be a tough task to take them back down a notch.
We've seen time and time again, I mean, this is famous for Sean Garrett is playing quad at one of the majors. He was playing quad all by himself, and his teammate wasn't even near him. If you're going to play in the A site on an anti-eco, you need to play one in sight looking on the front side of quad and the other person behind quad. What this creates is that if they come from the right side of red and they try to push you quad, your teammate's in sight ready to mow them down. And when you have an MP9 or MP7, extremely easy to do so. And if they push the right side towards you, if you're playing quad, you can also help your teammate out. So it's a huge crossfire there. And if they go to the left side of red towards truck or towards forklift, you have a guy rooting from cat. So they played a little bit differently. They had 2 guys in sight. The T's were able to wrap around quad and actually flank them and shoot them in the back of the head with Glock. So they picked up not only a bomb plant, but they did it with Glock. So huge round by them. They were able to buy AKs, full armor, full nades this round against 4 rifles and a P9 from the CT side.
And we're actually going to see Nexus with an incredible read here on the B bomb site. They're going to have 4 in the vicinity. 4-shot going to be rotating out of Z there. And yeah, here we go. We have the Dream Tanks try and take up towards the B bomb site, but it is really not going their way at all. Not a single frag as Alien last one up. And where did that go wrong, Hano?
Alien now. Where is the nades? I don't know what they use. They had full nade sets, but yet they don't have a smoke for lower CT to take a B bomb site. I don't know where they use all the nades. I honestly don't know. But
yeah, it seemed like they wasted all of them very early. I think once they actually went to take in, they maybe had a couple Molotovs, but that was the extent of it. So, yeah, like you were highlighting, the fact that they got a bomb plant in the first and they save in the second, you're going to get that AK buy in the third, albeit it probably won't be the best buy that you're looking for with all those nades. But if you get 2 bomb plants in a row, you are sitting pretty. You got everything in that round. So the fact that, yeah, when they end up taking it to be there, maybe a bit of a misplay as they just didn't have the utility that they started off with that would have probably granted them easier access into the site.
I'd like them to download this demo and break down where they use all their nades and really push the button on why did we throw these smokes here and not here. I mean, if you're going to take the bombs, if your strat caller says, look, we're going to do a default, we're going to head to B, save a smoke grenade, boys. Like, we need to have a smoke grenade for at least lower, maybe not upper, but at least lower.
See an A side take here as Prince able to take down one, but yet again, they are going to be able to take down Plank's. 4-shot still alive. Finally goes down as they are going to create a 2-on-3. The bomb is not down, though, as Love to get a plant in this situation, but Thug Waffle now in a 1v3 loses his teammate, and they played a little bit passive in that end situation as it looked like they wanted to find at least one more before going for the plant, but in the end, they do not get the plant at all. That being said, they still have a good economy coming into this round. Well, not good in the sense that they get a full buyout. They're going to have nothing left over, though.
We knew on CT side it was going to be rough for them. Like you said, there's a lot of raw talent from Nexus, and that's where you shine on CT side, is that you're going to be a heavy fragger because you have the advantage. And that's what's happening so far, is that there's been four solid rounds from the CT side and nothing, not even a glimmer of hope yet, other than the bomb plants from the T side.
Looks like they're going to peek towards A here. At least at the start, Plank's going to get aggressive inside of Squeaky and actually doing so with four shot behind. So the double Squeaky push, and Vanguard's going to try and spray through the smoke from A main to catch them out as they exit from Squeaky and head back in, into the bomb site. And that is, if you find some aggression towards Squeaky, that's usually, or towards A main, if you got a guy in Squeaky, kind of goes both ways. You want the other one to hopefully get a refrag or something to that effect, but you can see Nexus just allowed to get back into the site. But that being said, Vanguard's probably had to rush a smoke if you wanted to trade that, so probably a better idea to stay put. That being said, four shot deals the damage to Kamenar. Alien falls as well. So it leaves just these A main players in 45 seconds. Vanguard actually does find Char. But four shot onto Parole. Vanguard. Ooh, flanks. That was a nice shot to finish off Vanguard's. And that'll be another round here for the Nexus side. 12-8 as they seem to be running away with the CT side.
They've been more successful on their ecos than they have on their two gun rounds, it seems. So as a strat call, you need to say to yourself, what is working on these eco strats that we're running to get us bomb sites that gun rounds aren't? We're getting picked before we can execute. Is that what's going on? And that seems to be the case. So maybe once you buy your next gun round, maybe try something quick here. And awesome push by Nexus in that door. If you think that you can outshoot them, and you can, here's a flashbang actually from your main as well.
Oh boy, the lineup. Plank's gonna get two of them. I thought he'd line up a little bit more, but four shot will continue, and Kamenar just jumping right into the fire in the flames. Thug Waffle last up. 1v4 here as little spot Char kind of bolting towards his direction. Sends an 8 as well. Thug Waffle does peek back out and finds the Tech 9 frag. Can he get another one here? Looks like his crosshair placement. Not too bad, but Drone able to find that one before the Tech 9 did so. And we'll see a nice little replay here of that pop flash and bit of a spray down by Planks. And again, I thought for certain he was going to get maybe even 4 here, but they line up. The problem with it is he was blind as well, so that's where obviously he couldn't really focus much further than those first shots that he took. But good anti-eco there for Nexus, not losing too much.
I don't know about you, but if I see 4 or 5 people A main, I'm saying YouTube clip, let's go, and then I only get like
right.
1 or 2.
This is my chance for a highlight reel. That's for certain. I think, to be fair, I think he would have, but again, he was like full blind, and I don't know if that was actually I don't think the CT flash hit him. I think it must have been they had maybe one flash with those T's as they entered, and it popped right at the exit. Nonetheless, still had some good work done there, and now Dream Tanks, like you were saying, you wanted to see a fast play. Again, we're not seeing it here as they slowly lurk towards the boost spot.
They're more team-oriented, and I think that if you're going to be team-oriented, and instead of spreading out like they're not targets to pick, Vanguard's just get a trade on it, though, so that's good by the terrorist side. But if you're playing against a team that you're not going to be able to outshoot, or you don't think that you can outshoot, then you need to play as a more solid team, and you can't let the CTs break down your T-side strats by them pushing you and outpicking you and getting the upper hand and turning things into 5v4 situations. So either need to execute quickly, or you need to really hold down those spots and stop them.
Nice nade there. Plank's going to go down, and now this leaves an option. With 30 seconds remaining, do they try and take up Highway? Looks to be the case, as four shots still alive and well from Truck. Now he's going to have to provide a big defense here. Oh my god, I saw that collateral coming. They both line up, and four shot. One shot, two kills. Now he's going to throw that nice Molotov that we were talking about. Oh, he botches it, actually, as he will not land at that default plant spot, but that was the one we were referring to as now 2-on-3. Vanguard's, and actually it's Parole to find the first frag, and he's going to find a second one. Four shot. They both found 3 frags in this round. Four shot could, in theory, have stuck it there, but instead he peeks out, catches Parole holding W, and that will be the round. Beautiful 4K from four shot. And Nexus well on their way to a map 1 victory.
The CT side has been completely flawless as of right now. I mean, that's the only close round I think we've seen so far where it's come down to like a 1v anything. I think it's been a 1v2 on the first eco round, I believe. And then they had Glocks that got the bomb down. But regarding that, the only thing that's been this close is that round. T-side, though, they have full nades here. They have four Molotovs, full AKs, full everything because of the bomb plant. The other thing that I wanted to press on is that if you're planting the bomb and you have a lot of time, this wasn't the case last round, but I don't think people realize how important bomb plant spots are. If you can plant the bomb, if you have the open sight, four shot, almost walls this guy. But anyway, so if you have an open sight and you can plant for A main, absolutely plant for A main. Stop planting default just because you're thinking to yourself, I gotta get the bomb down. You don't have to plant it right there. Plant it somewhere where you can plant for A main. Make this situation a little bit easier for yourself. So not that round, obviously, but in any round.
Yeah, no, I completely agree. And we see that could even just be the turning point in a lot of rounds is the bomb plant positioning when that defuse comes in. But we actually saw Drone get boosted up and find a frag into Sunroom to kill Alien there. And that's actually something I haven't seen in a long time, but it's super cool when it comes out as, again, just death from above. Alien has pretty much no feedback or info that boost is coming in. And luckily, Pro will be able to take down Savior and actually takes down Drone as well. So finds the frags coming back, but Char with two of his own finally goes down to Cam NR, and we do have a 2-on-2 once again here. We do have an Incendiary coming down to the back of sight. One playing that position, and Cam NR blindsided Vanguards from B main. Sends some spray to four shot here, but ooh, leg down to 60 hit points, and Planks already on the bomb, giving him no time at all to take him off that defuse. So 15-8, one round away here, as like you were stating, that flawless CT side. It continues. Although they gave up some frags, nonetheless, 2v2, they retake.
Perl, or however you want to say his name, when
right.
when he entered the site, he realized that CT was smoked and Upper was smoked, so he didn't enter the site by going up the ramp. If you go up the ramp, you have multiple positions that you can be shot from. He actually swung all the way around, took a less tight of an angle around to the side, and actually went up towards headshot, walked up towards headshot, and that's the way that you want to take that, is so that you can actually aim forward and only be shot forward because you have your back against the wall, obviously. So, beautiful take by him, picked up a kill on the CT who was playing in the B site, but Drone held it down enough for Char to come in through that smoke and pick up two huge frags to retake that bomb set.
RG tanks, they are going to go with a slow play here. Once again, Alien working up towards Checkered, and he's going to find his way all the way in here, and Drone, if he's not careful, he's going to send an aid towards B main, and that's going to give the info to Alien. Well, if he knew I was in Checkered, he would have naded here instead. So pretty obvious that Alien kind of behind enemy lines, and he's actually going to call for his teammates to rotate on over. Now, see how this works out, as currently smoke's down. They do have a lot of nades to play with, though, and again, with Alien inside of Checkered, being that he has a smoke and Molotov, they could come up with some creative plays, but here they go, as the smoke comes down in heaven. Alien gonna head towards headshot. They do not smoke off lower, unless I'm just not seeing things. No, finally they do, but Foreshot pushes it and finds one. What a play from him, and now Cam NR, last one up, 1v4. Nexus taking a book out of Dream Tank's book and just kind of flashing. Or I don't even think Foreshot had a flash, so he just ran right through the smoke of the CT or into that headshot area. And big frags from him. Yet again, though, we see that lack of a CT smoke, and when it does come down, Foreshot just bolts on through it.
It's almost a free frag for the CT. I mean, if you're running two or three people across and the guy is an op, absolutely free kill for him. You got to smoke that off. Play it slower. You don't have to rush everything. If you have a teammate who's sitting in Checkers, you know that you don't have to clear Checkers at least, right? Like, the only thing that they can be is in sight. Once you set up a few Molotovs, you can kind of close off some of the positions in sight that they can be. They Molotov, I believe, the middle of sight, so the only place they could be is tall box or headshot, or even further back behind spammable, but didn't smoke off CT. Foreshot got a free kill on it, ran through the smoke, another kill, and took down the round.
Very nice stuff, as Nexus will take map number one.